A way to evaluate your concepts is by using the matrix sorting template, and we will now show how to use it. So the most critical part of using the matrix sorting is to define your criteria. In this example, we will use the criteria of the concept should be cheap to produce and fast to implement. And your criteria should always have a formulation that defines a high and a low. So for example, here it would be cheap and expensive. And for the other axis, it would be fast to implement and slow to implement. But of course, the criteria completely depends on your project and should be carefully considered either through a workshop or predefined. So you have your criteria. Make sure that your participants know your criteria and know what they mean, and also the concept. And then through discussion in the group, you agree on, okay, where does these concepts fit on these axes? So you might have a concept that is this fast to implement and this cheap, and you would then mark your concept here. Optimally, you have one template per concept, so for it to be more simple to read for all participants, you only have one dot. That dot can also be a post-it, and if you have a lot of concepts that you really feel like your participants can like compare and see in one template, you could, for example, also have a concept that is much slower to implement and but still cheap, and that would then be marked here, or something that's fast to implement but very expensive would be here. So your top concepts would always be aimed to be in the right corner. And that is pretty much how you use the matrix sorting template.